It's the liquor of ages, the tonic of conquerors. Find your spark. Gin and tonic, making men into giants since 1857.
Clogged pipes and plugged up toilets can bring a busy family to its knees. At Stinkweed, we know and understand you and your family just don't have time for that. Stinkweed, fast, professional plumbing you can count on. Call 2-in-a-black, DREDGE5. That's 2-in-a-black, DREDGE5.
I was brought to my knees by Stinkweed drenched my pipes.
Deluxe Coughs Wild Mongrel Bubblegum. Blows colored bubbles. Changes colors while you chew. Discard your old brand for something new.
The Lexicos Wild Mongrel Bubblegum. It's yummy.
The Marilagia. If you are going to drink like a wizard, then you must release the beast.
Marit Lager. Crack the ice and release your beast. Available at all fine Sinclair superstores.
Worm would like to remind you to drink responsibly.
Hello, everybody. It's Deluxekoff back at ya. We're going to jump right in to our deck list here. Say play league match. As you can see, I'm going to be running this red-green creation. I have played this before. I've made a few changes to it. Hey, Nichols, good to see ya. And Arch Naomi's been here a while, keeping her company and stuff. Sorry, my headphones are a little loud over in the corner here. Hey, Sharazaman, good evening. All right. So, I wanted to play this because it's my birthday today, and I think I'm 42. It's either that or 41. I think after 21, it stops really mattering, right? But I made a few changes to this list. I'm not doing so well. I'm 1-2. I've played this before, but since I was feeling selfish and it's my birthday, I was like, hey, you know what? I'm going to play what I want. So anyway, that's what we're doing. You'll notice I've got Tranquility on the sideboard here. I was running into, what's his name, Saptox. And quite a few of the Millstone decks, and about the only way out of that lock is to blast away. And I prefer Tranquility over Serene Heart because it just grabs everything, and it's mana's never an issue. And there's sometimes like I forget between auras and enchantments, sometimes stuff can fall through the cracks. So, Pog Champ, what does that mean? Well, thanks, guys. Yeah, in fact, I got this. I've never opened one of these treasure chests, so while we're waiting for this, I guess since it's a birthday theme sort of today, I guess we'll just open one, see how this works. Let's see. It says, "Are you sure?" Yes, open one. Let's see what happens. All right, we got Flooded Grove. That's not bad. Nice Simic land. Ooh, beautiful art. It's always weird for me to open stuff that isn't common. It's like, what are these things? And some Devoid card. Whenever you cast a colorless spell, Molten Nursery deals one damage to a creature or player. That could get fun. And this. Boy. Okay, well, not sure about that. We'll open one more. Maybe I sold a bunch of them. I thought I sold them all, but then I still saw these sitting here. So we got Jarena, Azura of War. Hey, let me know if any of these are worth selling or if it's probably just all junk, I would imagine. I'd like to pop a Force of Will here, but we'll see. Flying, put a 1-1 counter on it. That's a nice little Bant card. Ah, and what's this? We've got Render Silent, counter spell. Its controller can't cast spells this turn. Ooh, that's nasty. Reminds me of the old invasion days. Flooded Grove is 5 tickets. All right, well, I'll make a note to myself to sell it. And let's see, this is some skeleton key here. Alrighty, So let's, geez, oh, Pizzo, is there anybody? This is what I was worried about. The last 2 days, I don't know what's going on, but it is just taking forever to, the average time is like 4 or 5 minutes for people to come up. And I've heard that there's some new algorithm trying to match you with people. And I played Elves, I think, 4 times to a 4-1 finish. And so I think it bumped me up and kind of tries to wait on people that are a little meaner, if that algorithm's true. I've just heard rumors about it just a while ago. So I'm going to keep that up. We're going to go back over here, and I'll open one more just for the heck of it. Yes, I'll open one. And let's see. We got, I've got like 10 of these. Planner Cleansing. Some Common Backwoods Survivalist. And boy, I got butchered on that one. Although that artwork's pretty cool for Loam Dryad, but whew, wish I would have sold that one. Anyway, all right, that's enough for the birthday crap. Anyway, for people that don't know or are watching this on YouTube a little bit later, the changes I've added to this deck, I'll go over the deck list since we're waiting for an opponent. Evolving Wilds, I put one in there just because of the early Pulse of Murasa. You know, I've been over this a few times. This deck wants AND mana, A-N-D, not O-R, or. That's why I run almost the full 8. I just threw on an Evolving Wilds there. There's just sometimes I wanted to go fetch something early on, so that's there. We've got just an ocean of removal, 4 Seal of Fires, 4 Lightning Bolts, 4 Flame Slash, 1 Flame Jab, Firebolt, 3 Faithless Looting. Able to power these out pretty quickly. This is a really underrated card. Pulse of Murasa, 3 of them. Sylvan Ranger, I've tried just seriously, every card there is in green that goes and gets a land, and this is the one I settled on. That 2-drop is very important. Eats edict effects and goes in hand with these guys really well. And also, later you go grab a land, you can pitch it to looting, or you can pitch it to a flame jab. And then the young wolves eat up edicts and aggro and stuff like that. The changes I already want to make to this deck, because I just lost a Tron. I lost a Stompy. We'll replay that one. I beat the RDW deck, the Goblins. Red deck win style. You can tell why it's got all this. Yes, it so far it still destroys Delver. In the sideboard we got 2 Electricry, 3 Tranquility. I already been over why. 4 Shaman, because I was looking at the standings and the decks I was supposed to face, and you know how that goes. You plan for ABC and all you see is X, Y, and Z. Haven't seen Affinity yet. Sure would like to, because this is a lot of good times and crying for the opponent. 4 Pyroblast and 2 Unearth. But the change I would make to this immediately is I'm going to add another Earth Rift to this. I'm just going to do it now. And honestly, I'm going to take out an Electricry. I normally had the Electricry a lot of times for the Hexproof matchup. And we got a match. And what ends up happening is with Tranquility now, you're able to kind of just obliterate stuff and run. So in theory, I haven't done it yet, but we shall see. Anyway, so we got a okay hand here. Got 2 Lutens we will keep. Haven't seen this list in a while. Says Nichols, does it still destroy Delver? I sure hope so. We'll be all right. This is just one of those pet decks. Like I said, it's kind of a selfish day, the whole birthday. Hey, speak of the devil, we shall see, won't we? I just love playing this darn thing. It's a lot of fun. So I'm going to bring out my Seal of Fire right away. I like the psychology behind Seal of Fire. Flint Smith, good to see you. Thanks for joining us. Anybody get the shout out for day's challenge done? Nope. All crickets, but I didn't expect much. We'll see. Yeah, I was looking around and stuff. Haven't seen much, but probably got to cap that at the first person to do it and so I don't go into the poorhouse. I don't even know how much days is worth anymore, but I sure like it when it's played against me, because I think I'm like, well, that's given elves too. It's a pretty darn easy one to beat. All right, so this, I do actually wish this was a dual land instead. As you can see, we have all this stuff. Well. Yeah, you know what? I'm going to burn this here. Okay. We'll pop that and we'll get rid of the sprite. Maybe not the best of plays, but I'd rather this flipping instead of a... oh, good. That signifies he's probably got a hand of nothing, so we'll see. Oh, and I've been, if you're wondering, my wife, she totally made my year, and I'm gonna blow this up now. Three's nothing to sneeze at. I'm kind of screwed on land, but she totally made my year for my birthday. As everybody knows, if you follow us here and stuff, I'm kind of a space geek. I really like anything to do with space and stuff. So there's Day, speak of the devil. Nope. You can have your little young wolf tempo. But she got me, which is pretty hard to do, I found out, into the JPL, the Jet Propulsion Laboratory. And just a real cool day, and I got to meet a lot of things. See, so I'm sporting this new shirt. I'm just loving it. Got a cool hat too. It says Mission Juno on it. And got to see the control center, and it was just awesome. It was like Disneyland for most people, but for me it was just awesome. So if you ever get that chance, go for it. So he seemed wanting to counter the young wolf, so I'll see if I can make him bite on this, because what I really want to do is loot. Good. We got somebody that's counter happy. We love that. All right. Now I'm going to cast what I really wanted. Got another days? Nope. Oh, boy, look at this. Oh, we're not going to be casting these guys anytime soon, and we have the pulse already in there. So, boy, glad I didn't draw that two turns in a row. Maybe we won't beat Delver on turn our game one. We shall see. So here comes the little mad sprite. That's good to know. Our opponent's a little counter happy. Maybe they're going and looking for the next days or two. Good taste in art, though. Nice new ones. Dun dun dun. Gushing and dazing. All right. We really want to land here. Come on now. Ooh, okay. Well, tempo of the turn. Boy, I'm really tempted to just. We've got to land in there. Yeah, I gotta eat this now. She sounds awesome. Oh, she is. It's why I'm still with her. She puts up with my habit. I always laugh because I'll be playing online a lot. She never gives me a hard time or anything like that. I'm sure she might if I didn't provide that sort of stuff. But no, very cool. She's quite a gamer too. She's got a really mean Scrabble mind to her, and there is nobody better in the universe, I'm convinced, at, okay, I'll do this then. Let me go get the Evolving Wilds here. There's nobody better on Earth at that old Minesweeper game. I don't know if anybody remembers that, where the X's and O's and the bombs and stuff like that. She's just, that's scary when she's clicking through the minefield and stuff. We got ourselves a game here. You drawn poor and don't have the land. Let's thought that was going to reset our life total. Thank you for the birthday shout out. Good times. All right, so that's one fairy, two fairies. Killed one already. He's gushed. That's probably sitting okay. Let's see. Well, that's cool. I'll gain the life here. He's a bit counter happy. I'm gonna try to pull the trigger here with a little bit of a bluff. Make it sit there, make it real obvious. Let's see what we're gonna do here first. Nope, he's got it. Okay. That's fine. Getting a little worried. Got a three turn clock here. Let's see. Bum-ba-da-dum. How many days does Delver run? I know. What is this? This is usually it's two. Most standard lists. I haven't been as much of a student of the lists as I used to be. When I had four round tournaments and stuff, for some reason league play, I don't infiltrate and look up people. There's 90% of the time they're not on there. In the old days where the same tournament regulars would show up, I was a lot more apt to do that, but. Well, I'm going to pull this. Don't think we're going to win this one. Counterspell. Okay. Let's go like this. Days number three. Nope. Getting grim. Yeah, usually two. Yeah, so I went to JPL, and that was just an awesome, awesome, awesome time. I just can't explain how cool it was, because they had the Mars heat shield for the next mission to Mars in 4 years, They had a replica of the same one because they already know it works. So it was just a trip knowing that, hey, wow, 20 feet away from me, that thing's going to be on Mars in 4 years. So I was flipping out about that. So good times. All right, off to sideboarding. We don't need any of the young wolves. I'm going to get rid of all my young wolves. We'll bring in some electricaries and some all the pyroblasts we can hold. And maybe lose a flame slash. What do we need? One more card gone. I love pulses. Just I treat them like creatures. I'm really tempted to run four. And I almost played the Flash Gordon deck today too. That would have been a fun one. Let's go. I'm gonna lose a Derm here. I'm going to go like this. This is looking grim, says Arch Naomi. Yes, and indeed it was. But hopefully with this ocean of red and our untouchables, we'll be able to do something here a little bit more effective. You'd think I'd be having a better day on my birthday, but we are. There's a lot of L's on my little sheet of paper here. So this is all right. Good times. I'm pretty convinced I don't like days. That's probably why I'm trying to always give them away as prizes, because everybody else wants them, and I don't know, that tempo loss is just extreme, but they seem to play it well. So here, if they daze this, that's great. You know, it's a 3-to-1 mana ratio after that. It's just craziness. So I've already got two green in this deck. You really want to favor red, so I'm just gonna go grab that. You know what? I had two in my hand. I probably should have grabbed a green there, but who knows. It's fun later on when you get the flame jab rolling and stuff. And let's see, we have really no play there. All right, I'll go fetch green here then. Then we'll be ready for Blastoids next turn. Sitting there waiting on that sprite, hoping for the days. Nope. I do like that little play on words that we had when we had the Rats for Days contest, because it was like, I just like the play on words that caused. But, oh, anyway, so I've been editing for well over, I think it was 44 hours, the last count I had on this. It's about a 6-minute segment, and it was going to be an episode 3, but like I said, we're just going to kind of negate the whole space opera angle from moving forward and just go the way of the, where it's just the good. Sorry, I'm getting distracted here, guys. Let me, I'm going to slow play this. But anyway, it's just a mammoth segment, and it's called the Deck List Assist, and it's pretty much, I'm sure you've all suffered through this, where you have a deck that's 70-80% there, and you just can't quite get it. There's something missing, and such. And so this is a list that's just, it kind of reminds you a lot, kind of like the Sideboards Explore, but on a lot deeper level, and just almost a checkpoint system of judging your deck and what it needs. And every time I've broken the rules, stuff like this happens where I'm not really doing too well. So I love the end of turn pulse. Just try to draw out some. Oh, I was hoping he was going to counter that. All right. Well, now let's see. Well, we're out of the range of, you know what. So we'll throw a Derm out there and see if it bites. Here comes Counterspell. At least we're not going to fall for a daze. Okay. Nice hard counter there. And we've got double Firebolt probabilities. So let's see how this goes. At 28 life, it's going to take that thing a lot of work to come on over that many times. Yeah, I was going to play that Flash Gordon Death Touch deck, and actually did play it, and I it just did atrocious. I think I went 1-4. Yeah, always really close, but oh my gosh, it was just it was brutal. So then I was like, you know what, this is the one I always feel like, but boy, this is when we really want to see Flame Jab show up. This is getting ridiculous. We have 6 lands left now, 5. Do I walk in? You know what? I don't want a sprite. I'm going to just block the ninja. And then I'll be able to at least double Firebolt next turn and pull it off. Elves is pretty insane, says Arch Naomi. It's been super. I've been super impressed by it. I think I might end up liking it more than tokens. Yeah, I'm that way too. I don't think I've ever this last year. I'm not trying to boast, but I think the worst I've ever done is even like 4-1. It does that a lot. It just has so many auto win matchups. I mean, it just shreds Delver. Not quite as much as tokens does, but my version tends to, just because of the obscene amount of life gain that's present. But come on, Electricery. Oh my gosh. Not my day, guys. Let's go I'm going to bluff. We got a Derm behind this. Just want to lose the advantage here. Come on, Sprite. Where are you at? I still got Days back up. I don't know if they probably just take him out, though. And we'll grab that Delver. Flood's good for something. Boy, he doesn't have a Sprite. Oh, boy, I could have saved a turn. All right. Boy, what we really want, other than a land, is I think we only have 4 lands left in our deck, and there are 44 cards. So MTGO does not know that this birthday boy is getting awfully sad. I like Terry Pratchett's quote, Shirazaman. He said, I think it was Granny Weatherwax in the book I was just reading, said, "Old is something that happens to other people." Thought that was a pretty cool little quote. I'll have to put it on a card sometime. Yeah, I loaded up the coffers with elf winnings, and as usual, I got kind of not tired of it. I always like elves, but you know, you just want to take things out for a spin. I guess it's a lot like cars. Not that I'm a car guy. About the furthest thing from it. Okay, here we go. Oh, and if any of you have music that you think would be good for Pauperganda, or stuff that is kind of rights-free and that sort of thing, or you never know who's... I know I've done 2 albums myself, just little silly, almost like a old Toad the Wet Sprocket, or I've actually been referred to as... I think it was Tracy Chapman was the one I get the most as far as just guitar stylings and stuff. But anyway, if anybody has original music and wouldn't mind sharing it or using it, then good times, let me know. Oh boy, this is grim. Okay, we actually like this card right now. Cool. Yeah, we'll discard this and this. Let's go like this. That was a pretty good card, wasn't it? Should I loot again? Let's cancel. Let's loot again. Boom, boom, boom. This is why we loot. Boy, oh boy. I think we are out of lands. Boy, do you grab the... You know, I think I want to kill the ninja. I think I want to kill the ninja. What do you guys think? He might have a daze, so let's play that. All right. Any votes? I don't know if we're going to survive. Well, we're at 19 life. We better draw good. I don't think we have any lands left in the whole deck. Yeah, so these draws will start getting very nice. I'm going to go with the ninja. Yes, always kill the ninja. Just checking, guys. Making sure everybody's on board. Wish we could get rid of that delay. Hopefully in the future we can start doing some stuff. Yeah. Yeah, I was actually going to try to play the Simic deck, because I was trying to play something blue at the request for last week, but like I said, that color smells me a mile away and usually doesn't like me much, so. All right. I'm going to go like this. Pull off the Blaster Derm Bluff. He doesn't buy it. Good for him. All right. It's getting grim again. Man, oh man, yeah. We double lost to Stompy, double one on Goblins, double lost to Tron, and I should have brought in Tranquility, because I remember that guy. It was an old school player with the COP green, and I can do enough damage with red in this deck, but it takes a long time, and as you'll see in the replays, he double crushered me. It was brutal, but awesome. Okay, this is getting grim. Let's grab the Sprite. Come on, sucker. All right. Boy. You know, this one and the Simic Advanced deck, or the Flash Gordon, the one that I have, I usually go like 3-2 or sometimes 4-1 with it, but I usually break even and have a lot of fun doing it. For some reason, boy, both RG Tempo and I keep trying to like prove it live, like this is a good deck, and it's not helping me at all. We're getting, like I said, when we were at 44 cards left, I think we only had what, 3 or 4 lands left total, and then we drew some. Remember that second activation of the Faithless Looting that actually caused more lands to come up, so pretty trippy. Alrighty. Hopefully I can pull off a win in one of these two games. I'll play the replays as usual. And say it now if you want to see all of them. There are only two each, so I should play most of them. Sometimes the games get awfully repetitive, and we're definitely going to lose this one, guys. Oh my gosh. The very last land we have. There it is. Okay, well, this deck does not want to win today. I will redesign and assess again. So we've got one more coming up here. I'm going to go use the facilities real quick, and I'll be right back after this.
Water. Delicious, refreshing water. From ocean to sea to lake to pool to pond to puddle to drop to drip. Water, chemical symbol H20, is all around us. It's the giver of life. And it's there with us from our first cup of tea in the morning to our nightly bithuvi.
I say...
But what is water? It's a difficult question because water is impossible to describe. One might ask the same about birds. What are birds? We just don't know. But we do know that water is the most powerful substance on Earth. And whatever form it's in, be it ice, vapor, or just water, it has the capacity to affect whatever it comes into contact with. Ruined.
I'll take that, mother.
Hey everybody, I started the queue before I left and still nobody, so I'm going to discuss some other stuff here so we don't have any dead air. Let's see, so the changes we're going to make, I'm running a little, 21 land does feel just perfect for this deck, but I'm not thrilled about this Wilds. I know the Pulsar Mirasa idea, I'm going to go back to what I had before with 4 and 4, and we'll go back over here and talk about what I almost played. The Flash Gordon / Simic weird creation deck. Let me move this stuff over. The one I posted on Facebook, I actually deleted it because looking back at it, I was just riddled with issues, and I, having a break from the Drake ban and stuff like that, I kind of redesigned it from the ground up, and I looked back at it, and I was like, ugh, this is ugly. So we run 3 pulses in this as well. Hello, Pulse, there we go. 1 Wing Quaddle, and that's mostly for like cards like Sohana Ledgewalker and stuff where you just have to have a blocker because sometimes a spider doesn't get there. We've got the Ambush Viper. The reason I call this Flash Gordon, if anybody is lacking coffee, I used to run Pestermites and Spellstutter Sprites, and then that with the Ambush Viper, everything had flash and end of turn and go get it again and stuff. So very, very, very fun deck. I did add 1 Bone Splitter just so I can turn my Trinket Mages into 4/4s and stuff, but kind of quiet in the chat, guys. I just want to make sure I'm still, being heard and receiving and all that stuff. There wasn't any technical difficulties. So just type anything in there if you don't mind. This powers out the Cloudfin Raptor, Shield Sphere, and Dreamstalker to just kind of keep bouncing stuff back and forth and plays double duty with a lot of stuff. Very fun, synergistic deck. There's 21 lands in this now. I was getting got screwed a little bit. And I go back and forth on Ona's Grace with this deck a lot, and I just don't like drawing it in this deck because you do want to plant stuff down because these bows take 3 mana to power up. And anyway, so mostly because of First Strike and Ledge Walker, this deck was... Oh, yeah, who doesn't love Flash Gordon? Thank you, Flint Smith. Good, I'm glad I'm receiving. It was just getting a little quiet there. So I went with 3 Auraflex in the sideboard because, you know, with a lot of times I did lose to Hexproof. And, you know, yeah, you've got a poisonous body, but then the First Strike gets you. So this has been, if you have blue, this has been it's a pretty awesome card for that. You know, looking at it now, it's like, well, why don't I just run Tranquility again? And because if we look, we don't really have any enchantments that'll mess with that. So might want to make a note to myself about that, too. It's funny coming all the way back full circle to Tranquility because, you know, it seemed like kind of a vanilla blah card, and there's so many things that do that. But it's just kind of the Wrath of God effect for that, and it's just awesome at what it does. So I move this to the sideboard, just one of them, because... if they do bring in like Stompy or something, and they do bring in like Gleeful Sabotage, and they're just trying to kill your combo with the Longbow, I just wanted a way to get it back. And this little Workshop Assistant, and it's good with black too, you know, just eats a few edicts, and it's out of Shrivel range, and it's not worth more than one spot. And this is the key of the deck. Last time I played it, I forget what we went ended up going. It was like 3-2, I think we went with this the last time I played it. But this card's awesome because, you know, you sit back, you have like maybe an equipped spider, and they rush at you, and they know you got to kill your own guy, and you can ping one, and so you block, you ping, and then you cast this, and both their things die. You get saved because of the fog effect, and then yeah, it just really throws math off. It's one of my favorite fogs whenever I can think of playing it. Terrifying Presence, plus it looks like where I used to grow up, so there's always that angle too. 4 Hydro Blast, we got 3 Sandstorm. Again, good for early rushes with Hexproof and such, and the Terrifying Presence, and that clear it up. So anyway, my goodness, this is just in 5 minutes now. Sorry about that, guys. Nothing I can do about that. Let's see. Nope. Going back to here. Going here, and... all right, we'll open one more treasure chest. Open one. Dun, dun, dun. Hope we had a little drum roll. All right. Yes, I have. Oh, thank you, Nichols. That's right. I'll open this and then we will discuss that. Let's see. Route. Oh, cool. Nice. I don't know if that's going to be worth much, but I used to love holding on to that. And we've got Havoc Sower, Devoid. Yeah. And Prey Upon. Oh boy. Yeah, I'm gonna stop opening these. They're much better to sell. The one day I was supposed to sell them, and they were really high in price, and then I went back and it wasn't that high in price. So Nichols shared with me a very cool deck that, thank you for the prompting and for sharing it, because it gives us something to do while we're waiting forever. Treasure, says Arch Naomi. Yes, but he said if I'd ever run into this, and I haven't, but I've heard a few people mention it. He's able to dig up this list. There it is. Thank you, Shiraz. Man, you guys are on it. Uses the new Ash Barons card, so I can't really zoom in on this. And we've got just a bank configuration, but Coiling Oracles and Oromancers and Quasal Pride Mage. Oh, of course, right when we're talking. More on that later. We'll get the last round in, and then we'll discuss it at length and see what you guys all think of it and stuff. I haven't even boarded it up yet, but we'll keep this. These are the kind of hands, too, with access to Pulse of Morasa, you want to, you know, you loot and you throw it in there and you go get it later. It's just really, really like it when it works like that. But we got early damage, and hopefully we can see. Let's see what we can see. All righty. We're going to go off to the races and try to keep up. One for one. Maybe it's elves. Maybe it isn't. We'll see. Maybe it's Stompy. Boy, what was it, a week ago? Every single match I saw was Stompy. It was just ridiculous. All right. We'll throw this on there. Ah, boy. Oh, boy. This is a tough one. You know he's got vines. I'm going to pop it now. I'd rather take... I don't want to give him his little boost on his end on his turn. Hey, look at that. Yeah, I was just facing off. I think I'll replay one of the losses. I was really surprised I lost it. It was against guy only had Wild Mongrel, and I just kept burying it with removal, and he kept sack, get rid of the forest, throw the forest out, throw this out, and it was like, gosh. But, you know, he ended up winning the game, so all the power to him. It worked. This is where I get a little nervous. Yeah, we got to go green. I'll throw it down. We'll hope for a block. Hope for haste. What am I talking about? I love some Angelic Renewals, says Shirazon. Yeah, I've tried to break that card a lot. And I remember the Sarah McLaughlin spoof thing we did with the SPCA ad with Pauper cards. I think I played that just last week. That's definite electricity in this build. Okay, and now we are conveniently screwed. Most misunderstood card in Pauper. So many players this thing causes. God, I hate the artwork, though. It's good when I keep the card small. Speaking of small, I'll make them a little bit bigger. We're not facing elves, so we'll make this nice and fat. How's that, everybody? Yeah, keep our graveyard down here. There we go. Alrighty. We're off to the races. Trosman says, yeah, I'm sure I've played a similar list in the practice room this week. Yeah, there's no shortage of bandwagon jumpers, that's for sure. Boy, I'd kill for an electricity. Gotta wait for game two. Come on, we gotta pull off one of these, right? All right, so let's go like this. I'm gonna attack with both because I can't really block anything, and it might be neat to have access to pull some Marasa later. Go grab it. Doesn't always have to be a blasted arm that it grabs, but we'll see. Gonna be at 20 life. Well, not after I hit him anyway. Maybe he's quickly doing an internet search. What does flanking do? We'll start hitting with the big guns. And against Stompy, I will block like crazy. A lot of times, you know, you walk right into a groundswell and you lose your derm. But hey, Pulsum Ross is there to save the day as always. So good times, good times. Ah, yes. Yeah, I'm actually excited to keep editing on this segment. I've been doing so much work in After Effects and all kinds of fun. I looked up the other day. I think I was like 6 or 7 hours. I was like, oh man, I almost didn't even move. And I've just been doing this, seemed like 24/7. Crazy. The order of when you play stuff, one of my bad habits is I like to F6. So I'll play all my stuff on the first main phase and then just F6 through it. It's just a habit over the years. But very, very bad in this scenario. You do want to attack first so that they, you know, don't get a gist of what the hell you're doing with regards to the creatures that you have access to. Like, you know, the decision to block is made very clear if I drop a blasted herb first and then attack with everything. Because then it's like, well, they might get in the alpha swing mentality is what I'm trying to convey. Is like, yeah, I'll take seven. Maybe I've got this X, Y, and Z in my hand, or this block might not have happened, knowing that there's another one behind it. But and here comes the pain. I'm just going to really try to put him under the pressure so he feels like blocking a lot. And we're still at 15 life. Feeling good. Boy, these cards are big. Must look better on the small end, though. Okay, now we're getting in the danger zone. All right. I like this. Okay, yeah, I like this. Let's give me something to do. Coming on over. Let's see what you got. Block it. Plop. I'm going to wait still on the firebolt in my yard. Let's see. I do like to have 6 mana. Even though we have flame jab and stuff. So I'm pretty tempted. I'll probably play that next turn. Because, you know, you got that firebolt and then you can seal. Or it's just it's a nice number for this list to sit at. I love when you just have basics. It's just like 3 and 3. If everything feels even and right with the world. Good stuff. All right. Reset the clock a little bit there. All right. What do we got here? Vines of Vastwood. I'm going to just walk right into. Is that what's going to happen here? I think so. We'll definitely play that, even though we're giving away what we're holding. And I'm always going to favor killing a Pitsulk over a Sentinel. Those things can just go completely invisible sometimes. Hey, it worked. Look at that. All right. And because we can block the Sentinel for days. So this guy, after gaining, what, 6, 7, 8 life maybe? It's getting grim. We're one spell away from beating Stumpy. Write that down as the last one here. Dun, 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 dun. See, it can do good stuff sometimes. Well, look what happens when we draw things in the right amounts. In my son's room, that's where I always broadcast from because of the insulation and lighting. But he got really into the old Rubik's Cube, the toy from the 80s, and he's got a very obsessive, compulsive mind. You get set on something, and he just won't give it up. And I love it about him, but it's maddening sometimes too, but definitely bring in some electricities here. But anyway, the reason I bring that up is there's all these Rubik's Cubes everywhere, and that kid, boy, he couldn't solve it. Went on YouTube, memorized about 10 or 15 algorithms, and now he can solve it in under a minute. It's ridiculous. So Joral Centaur is not that good in this matchup. So I'm gonna lose both of them and just bring in the electricity, and we're going to off we go. Hopefully we can go 2-0 on this one and jump on over to the list there. But so yeah, he's got the four-sided, the three-sided. Makes a good little stocking stuffer for the holidays coming up, though. Hopefully he's not watching this. Maybe get him one of those crazy ones on Amazon that has like 80 sides or something like that. Personally, the best I've ever done is two sides, but I'm not too keen on that. But it's neat seeing him do it. When he was little, he used to have a lot of coordination tests, you know, the Spock symbol, and then you can do the ones where the middle fingers stay together, and he couldn't do it, so he sat there for like 4 hours and just trained his dexterity to be top-notch, and wouldn't you know, he had it. It's always something my wife and I kind of giggle at when it comes to stuff with our oldest Alex. He's just very, very focused. Got to get it done. Okay. Well, that's better than hitting us. The one thing I do like about sometimes playing against Stompy, and you do it on your turn, so that, you know, you pull, obviously you can't pull a sorcery move on their turn, but whenever you have the option, if I had a lightning bolt, I would have done it then too, for the obvious reason. Maybe they've got a vines, and then you end up taking 6 instead of 4, and then it's just like you're preventing that much more damage on the backside. So good, good, good. All right. We've got some big targets here. We're going to drop this. And I'm going to take this out at all costs. I can block everything else. Good. So this can really feel ridiculous. I don't know if anybody remembers the... it was really popular about a year ago. There was a red-blue deck that... I think it was nicknamed Steady Fiend. At least that's what I called it. Because it was just very... It didn't have many bells and whistles as far as, you know, the Timur Battle Rage and stuff like that. But it just, you know, it had a lot of removal package just like this one, where it's just like keep everything off the board. And, you know, instead of an Alpha Strike, it would hit you for, you know, 10, 12 a turn. And it's very steady. And so this one shares a lot of the same base as that one does. All right, so we got a good play here. First we'll go Electricity. And then we'll go Flame Jab. Boink. Now we hope we get flooded because of Flame Jab. All right. And we got 2 good removal spells. He's got 3 cards left, and we're stable at 16. So this is feeling all right. Flint Smith says, swapping the stickers around helps solve Rubik's Cube. Yes, that was everybody remember when I was in grade school, I think that thing was all the rage, and that was you could always tell looking at somebody's gummied up old Rubik's Cube with all the stickers missing. It's like, yeah, sure, you solved it. But it's fascinating seeing my son do it. There's definitely little patterns and, you know, keys to doing it kind of the same way every time. Yeah, I need that just because the reason I made that ridiculous sound effect is I was thinking like maybe I should have pitched the Flame Jab out, but I'm just going to pull this off. I think he's probably sitting on a pit soak, brings this out, just wants to hit once and get some good. At this point, the person's probably just like, are you kidding me? I'm going to do it, guys. I'm just getting rid of it. Spawn a nice clear board for my Blastoderm next turn. I got a lot of respect for Quirion Rangers. Rangers of the Quirion Persuasion, you could say. And this will be fun. So I don't want to drop the Derm yet. I'm going to go grab an extra forest that we don't want to play. And we'll grab our Flame Jab. And finally, the deck is playing like it does when I'm playing by myself. This is just like, thank you, sir. May I have another? Okay. And we do want to run into this. Actually, no, this is all about the Derm now. And I'll hold the land. And we'll see. All right. Okay, there's a little bit of a problem, or could become a problem. We'll see. I think we're out of the woods. I don't want to speak too soon, but, you know, we're at 17 life, about to be 23 life. And we're looking all right. You know, I'm really tempted here. I want to Flame Jab this now, just so it doesn't come back to life. Go and get me. Cool. So now if he doesn't chump block, we've got some goods here. I just didn't want to have my 5 be wasted on a 1-1 that trips up. At least this way, we got the table nice and clear. Good to go. Go grab a forest. Maybe not play it. I mean, we do want 5 mana total, so I'm just going to wait because, you know, I could draw Faithless Looting, and that's always nice to pitch. Don't have to. I got 2 Firebolts locked and loaded, 23 to 18. Got a Derm on board. Maybe he's got a rank. Oh, hey, look at that. Okay, so we won. We went 1-1 live, and now we'll go over to the replays here. So it's frustrating because, you know, that was a win-win versus Stompy, and then we had a loss-loss versus Stompy, but before we do any of that, let's just run on over and stay on target with this cool deck that Nichols shared with everybody. Archenemy says, I used to be able to solve the Rubik's Cube, but I forgot how to do it. Yeah, it was so funny. I'd never see people in public doing it. It's like making a bit of a resurgence, and when I was off for those 2 weeks, we had that family issues up north. We were in the airport, and this girl was doing it with one hand, and man, she could pull that thing off in like 40 seconds. It was ridiculous, but she said she was some math major at MIT, and that was part of her like thesis, was to find a different way to solve it other than what they have online. And I guess there's numerous ways to do it, and just whatever I guess fits the bill for most people. But anyway, so this deck that Nichols sent, I mean, I'm kind of ignorant with it. It's not like I played it or made it, but it does have 2 Pulse Morasso, which we love, 2 Flickers, all the Angelic Renewals, and the ways to get them back and go hunt for them with the Monk Idealist and Oromancers. And what it really looks to do is abuse the Evoke mechanic, tripping Mole Drifter, which would trip the Angelic Renewal to come back, and then Walker of the Grove. So jump on over here, and let me see if I can... I don't even know if I have Walker of the... Nope. I thought I set this quantity to be at 0. Oh, that's why. We're here. Walker of the Grove. Let's see. Bring this up. There's one. Yeah. When Walker of the Grove leaves the battlefield, create a 4/4 green elemental creature token. And it evokes for 5. That's not that thrilling. I would swear there's a better thing to do, but I haven't seen the deck in action, and I've heard it's good when it goes on, so... Anyway, what we're going to do here is head on over to the replays. And we'll see what we can see. Yes, return to details. Okay, so match 1. This is the one I lost against Stompy. I'm just gonna do 1. If you guys want to see both, chime in now. But these games can... There's not too much tech. So if you want to, I'll get ready to slow down here. So he brings out, he's got main deck Scattershot Archer. It's kind of insult to injury. It's card's no good against us, and we still end up losing this game here. So at least we didn't see a Pit Sulk, if I remember right, though. He pops one. Nope, it's that one. So, you know, we've got at this stage in the beginning game, I'm definitely like trading these. They're not that great. And as you could see, I mean, we just prevented 6. So it's kind of like the same game plan with a lot of decks. You just survive that storm because you know you can get stuff back with Pulse of Marasa. So I will often block with a Blastoderm and stuff. And Stumpy just, you know, this guy just had a lot more firepower. This is what you hate. You know, you got to walk into it. But there was a good looting. I mean, we had a handful of Rugged Highlands and a little bit too slow against Stumpy. So we loot him out and go get some big toys to play with, and you know, be able to drop a Young Wolf, which is really good in this kind of matchup because it's a double blocker and all this good stuff. So as I said, I really respect Aquarian Rangers here. So I keep massaging the bottom of my legs. I've been sitting too much. I gotta get up and move here. Let's see. So here come the Blastos. I think you can see why I lose this one. I just can't. He's got just enough removal to squeeze things through. We lost our Derm. Everything's going to hell. We're at 13 life, fading fast. Got to pull some Marasa, so I'll stem the bleeding a little bit. But here I'm going to pause it just because it's a little frenetic right now. The Renegade Freighter, the new card, really, really seems to shine. As an opponent, I did not like seeing this, so I think it might deserve one spot in Stompy, but it's just one of those things. Well, it's just like the elf list. It's like, what the hell do you lose? You know, it's like, I don't want to lose anything. Let's see. And In theory, you know, edict effects and stuff like that should get a little bit worse, but so far, so good. We'll see. And I do remember, I think I made a really big play error here, and I just really felt terrible because it was like, of all the people, I think it's coming up next. That shouldn't fall for Aquarian, right? I mean, how many of my decks have those? And it's like, watch that, you know, it's like, duh. It's like, why? I should have seen that coming a mile away. So, deserve to lose this one. Deck list, says Nichols. Of which deck, sir? Dun, dun, dun. Because I know we were sharing the one that you shared. So just let me know what that's in reference to. I know that sometimes the delay can get maddening. But, yeah, and I did draw another card. And, what was it? I think it was a land again. So, anyway, so there's that one. Kill that. We'll go to round two. White Hot Hottie. I'm not quite sure what you're in reference to. Was it one that I just played, or we'll drop game one replays here, and we'll kill this, and here we go. We're going up against Thales, cool guy. Thanks, Asher. Got it. Okay. I'll have to look at that in a little bit later. So this is just a brutal matchup. It's not that his deck isn't good. It's just, this is kind of what you prepare for. And unless I get mana screwed, as you can see, it's just brutal. It's like, okay, I'll go get a mountain. I'll zap your guy. Now I've got a blocker. And it's like, okay, double block. I'm not going to let any of this damage through. I'm just like, eat it. So he's completely exhausted at this point. And, you know, we're stabilized at over 20 life. 28 now. Again, you know, it's like, boom, here we go. Set this up. I'm going to zap some stuff. Get another blocker out. Even trades. Still build. And, yeah. As you can see, I'm surprised the guy had a good attitude about it, because it just gets brutal. So here's a good example. Faithless Looting. We're able to go pitch the stuff we don't want. Block that any day. Bring out our dude. And what's really cool about this is this. Oh, it went a little fast there, but Goblin Heel Cutter has to target, so it's one of the few times I'm able to kill it. So I'll gladly trade my Centaur for this Heel Cutter, because it's just that repeatable damage. And with so many cards that require, you know, creature coming out to do anything, it's a no-brainer. I wish there was a way to play these back a little bit slower. It's great when it's boring, but when something happens really quick like that. So at this stage, you know, I'm holding back on lands for hopefully another looting. There we go. We pitch stuff we don't want. Boink. Put down a good guy, and we're off to the races. Love the idea of Pauperganda. Waiting for the time Wizards of the Coast makes it paper format. Keep up the great work. And, oh, happy birthday, says Kenwaku. Thank you, buddy. Appreciate it. Arch Enemy says, so let's say looking for one of the best reanimator decks or graveyard decks of some sort. Since I don't think reanimator is a very successful strategy, what would you recommend? I like the one that Alex Oldman posted with that's red and black. I didn't have much success with it. It was just like Stompy was last week. There was like a week where it was super, super hot and everybody wanted it. And it's just, it's that Vegas mentality. It's that intoxicating, like, when it works, that's all you remember. You're like, oh, my God, it was so great. You know, Omaha Crusher came right out with haste, and there's no chance for the opponent. And then you'll lose three or four games almost in a row, and somehow you don't really remember those as well. So I would recommend that one. I'll show you that list right now since we're on the topic. And then I'll show you how I got destroyed by... I think it's Exhumed Deluxe 3 was my favorite build. Yeah, this was the Exhumed deck of that I would go with personally. The main thing being... let me move this. I'll move it here. Move these over. Let me set this over by Converted Mana Cost. So this one does have the Neonate, the 4 looting, the 4 duress, which is really neat when you have a deck with 4... Duresses. This could probably use the new land Ash Barrens. I'm not sure. I still prefer 2 Crumbling Vestige, but plus that art. Oh my goodness. Gorgeous. Obviously 4 Exhumes, 2 Shred Memory. This is all standard stuff. 3 Dragon Breath. We've got Tormenting Voice, Manamorphous, Stinkweed, and Swirling. I did for a while run, and the Crushers, the other Cathartic Reunion. And for some reason, my memory is just on fire today. I'm not tripping over much. But anyway, Cathartic Reunion was in here for a while. I just didn't need it. Didn't like it too much. The big difference, this was, you know, when Drake was out. So I had these. I probably cut one or two of these. There's an extra Sandstorm back here. Some Pyroblast, some Shamans. I'd probably bring in. You know, I'm just going to do it right now. I'll bring in all four of them. And this guy, because this deck was really bad against Burn. And so it's really funny to, sometimes you can just play it morphed and block if in a pinch, but it's really funny to reanimate this with haste and go gain, you know, positive fire blasts. So anyway, there's that. Let me, I'll jump over to the chat here in just a second. Let me play the last replay. Where is it? There it is. Let's see. Dun-dun-dun-dun. Shirazamon Turbo Exhume or Crusher Control. Yeah, that's kind of what I've just showed. I mean, that's my version of it. And now we're going to watch me get destroyed by Urzatron. Do you guys want to see game? We'll play game one. I think this was the double crusher game. I mean, if you're going to die, do it in style, I guess, right? Let's see. Kenwaku, yes. That's Shirazamon. Oops. All right. Everybody's caught up. Dun, dun, dun. Kenwaku says, I would like to see Anime Dead be graded to a common, then all common set. Yeah, that would be awesome. The all common set. I really think, you know, enough time goes by that actually might make financial sense for them. You know, just that whole the reprint market and that cool place. What is up in Seattle that Bava was competing with tokens in, and I was totally oblivious to it, but it's so cool. They had the real tournament coverage and, you know, made Pauper really look like a big time format. But I know everybody's hurting for like battle screeches and stuff like that. It just shows, you know, what a drought causes in the game. So he's not hitting Tron yet, but the bad news is we're not hitting our Blastoderms, and I just give him too much time to pull out of this. We've got removal for days here. I'm not quite sure. Oh yeah, because I have Flame Jab in there. That's why I did that. Ran at him and trying to save on removal, because I was expecting the typical, what's the Fangrim Marauder, that gains you 5 life. So I was kind of holding back, and you know, at a certain point you just got to pull the trigger. I figured, you know, Lightning Bolt, Seal of Fire combo with any sort of blocking or Flame Jab shenanigans be good times. I kill my graveyard for the sake of the screen real estate size. Card Kingdom, yes, love giving them a shout out. Great stuff. One of these years I might make it up there and surprise show up, and that'd be a lot of fun. Double Crusher, how cool is that? Now, you know, just to like rub salt in the wound, it's like, oh, here's your Blastoderm. Gotta lose 4 things. This is just nuts. So I was thinking here, you know, maybe he's got a dead draw. That was pretty much my only out. Always like in poker, play to your outs. If you miss that, he Rolling Thundered us for like 16, so we die at -9. So anyway, we beat Stompy, we beat RDW Goblins, I don't know, some sort of hybrid. Lost to Tron, lost to Delver, and lost to Stompy. So we went 2-3, got the 40 points back, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, but this next week's going to be a lot of fun, guys. Be on the lookout. It might be sooner than later. I just don't want to commit to any sort of, exact schedule with regards to what I'm going to debut the new video and stuff, but you know, just moving forward, that's going to be kind of the format from now on, where it's not like I call it the space soap opera of me and Little Fight. They're just so hard to produce and do, and it's just taking so much time. And really, deep down, I think everybody just wants to see the segments of the show anyway. But we're definitely going to keep those coming when appropriate. I've never been a fan of just sometimes I say no to a few play, like Goldfish offered me a paid position and stuff like that. But you fall into that trap of, and you know, sometimes the Twitch can feel that way too, where it's like, okay, we already did that. It's like, why are we doing another video on that? So with regards to that, obviously with new set releases and things, we're going to showcase stuff, but I'm going to really focus on, you know, just the bare bones and keep making some really funny commercials and keeping everybody entertained. But anyway, guys, Shirazman says casual double crusher. Yes. Kenwaku, they had 64 players at their last Rag to Riches Pauper tourney. Yeah. And spread the word on that too. I mean, that's like real life Pauper there. That's just awesome stuff. And please let me know if you know something, because I think a lot of times people assume that I know a lot about the community and the format and stuff, and it's just kind of a selfish universe. It's like I'm so focused on a few things that sometimes, you know, that was all news to me. Like when I think Bava sent me a message like, hey, check this out. I made the top 8, and I was like, what the hell is this? I was like, this is awesome. So it was, like I said, it was all news to me. But anyway, guys, I'll see you next week. We'll have a lot more to talk about, and send any requests and all that good stuff, and we shall see you next time. Deluxikoff out.
Is there more to entertainment than 500-channel TV and zillion-dollar movies? Turning the sound up and your mind off? Is there still a place where fun involves thinking, imagining, doing? Some of us think so, and we find it in a game. Magic the Gathering. All you need to play is a brain, a deck, and a friend.